your mother's womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I chose you for a special work. I chose you to be a prophet to the nations. Then I said, but the Lord, I don't know how to speak. I'm only a boy. But the Lord said to me, don't say I'm only a boy. You must go everywhere I send you and say everything I tell you to say. Don't be afraid of anyone. I am with you, and I will protect you. This message is from the Lord. Then the Lord reached out his hand and touched his mouth. He said to me, Jeremiah, I am putting my words in your mouth. Today I have put you in charge of all the nations and kingdoms. Heavenly Father God, I come to Lord to say thank you. Thank you, Lord, for God, giving us, Lord, this new day. A day where we've never God seen before, and a day we'll never see again. Thank you, Lord, for God making this world for a special reason, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for God choosing us, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for God handpicking us, Lord. And Lord, we know, God, as kids out there, Lord, they think they can't let your kingdom come, and they think they can't let your will be done. But Lord, no matter what age we are, Lord, no matter what race we are, Lord, no matter, Lord, what our God, we are boy or girl, Lord. We can let your kingdom come and let your will be done, Lord. Because, Lord, we know, Lord, when you, God, give us strength, nothing's impossible, Lord. And, Lord, we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. So, God, continue, God, strengthening you, Lord. Continue, Lord, to let us, God, be an instrument of you, Lord. And continue, Lord, to let us, God, be a demonstration of you. And these good blessings are your daughter's son, Jesus, my prayer. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
2023. Yay! We would like to welcome our guests and members to our services today, and we hope that you will worship with us again. And we just want to remind everyone that the New Day Assessment is $25. Every Wednesday, prayer service is at 6 p.m. and Bible study is at 6:30. Please join us in person or on the call line. There is power in prayer.
Yes.
You can view our Sunday worship service and Bible study on our Facebook page, Metropolitan Baptist Church of Detroit, and YouTube page at NBC Detroit. Members, our popcorn is in. Please see Holly in the Sabbath room to pick up your order. If you would like to purchase Juneteenth t-shirts to wear next Sunday, please see Holly again in the Sabbath room after service. We have two upcoming events. On June 17th, food ministry is the last day for food ministry, and we will be closed July and August. If you need help or you know someone who needs help, please call the church office on Thursday between 10 a.m. and 12 a.m. On June 18th, Father's Day and Juneteenth celebration with Ralph Armstrong and his jazz trio.
Amen.
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 This is sponsored by the Detroit Federation of Musicians. Please wear your African attire, Juneteenth, or Black Pride clothing. This concludes our announcements for today.
Yeah.
So it is Youth Sunday, and we traditionally take time to honor our youth that are graduating from college or high school, and we also want to acknowledge our youth that are going from pre-K to kindergarten to first grade, fifth grade to middle school, eighth grade to high school. To our youth, when I call your name, please come to the front so that I can present you with your certificate of achievement. And I ask that the sanctuary applaud our graduates as they walk down the aisle. We have one collegiate graduate from Wayne State, from the Political Science Department. His name is Cameron Johnson, and his grandmother, Deacon Stovall, will accept the
There you go.
Our first member that I would like to come up today is Daniel Jones. Daniel has shown that he is a dynamic speaker, his prayer and reading of the scripture. On the fourth Sunday, he will be ordained as a licensed layman.
He wants you to believe, he wants you to live, and he wants you to surely testify about the goodness of the Lord. Because somebody in here knows that if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, I don't know where I would be.
Amen.
Because he's gotten me through many dangers, toils, and snares.
Yes.
And I can truly say that I've been young, and now I'm old. But I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread.
Yes.
It's prayer time in the house of God today, saints of God. And if you're standing in the need of prayer, I ask that you make your way to the altar. Because God wants to meet you at your need. Somebody in here knows that God can get you through whatever you are going through. Songwriter dipped his pen in the ink of inspiration and said, for every mountain you brought me through, for every valley you brought me through, for this I give you praise. And I don't know what your for this I will give you praise for, but somebody in here ought to be grateful for the grace, the mercy, and the loving kindness of God, because he looked beyond our faults and supplied us with all of our needs. We're praying for the family of the Sister Austin, the wife of our former Secretary of State, who died at 110 years old.
Wow.
And she was a member here, and I thank God that on December I was able to go to Dearborn to celebrate her birthday. Her services will be here later on in the week or in a few weeks. Let's continue to keep the Austin family in our particular prayers. We're praying for those who are having surgery on this week, that God will support them, that God will sustain them, and that God will strengthen them with his particular spirit. We're praying for our chairman of the trustee board, Brother Fred Johnston. We're praying for one of our former members who called me and said, Pastor, I know that you want me to know that you were in need, praying for me, and I'm in the hospital, and I couldn't get to her this week because of my voice. But I know that God can get to her. So we're praying for Mother Willie Mae Steen of Mount Calvary Baptist Church. You begin to pray silently,
soul with them and keep them hidden in the fire. Pray for those that are praying today. Heavenly Father, we thank you for our mind now last night and our room rise this morning. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for letting us see a brand new day, because we didn't have to wake us up this morning. But through your mercy, through your grace, and through your love and kindness, you look beyond all our faults and sorry deeds and woke us up. Father God, we also pray for the young people, Heavenly Father, of the church and of the world, that you continue to watch over them and bless them, Heavenly Father. And once again, we know that they are the future, Heavenly Father, that holds the key to a whole lot of things, Father God. We also pray for the pastor and this family. We pray that you continue to bless them and keep them and strengthen this man with your word, Lord God. Father God, we also pray, Heavenly Father, for the people of this congregation, those that are here, those that are alive, those that are not here, Heavenly Father, continue to lead them and guide them and bless them as well. Bless them with your word, Heavenly Father. Bless everyone, Heavenly Father, that is here, Heavenly Father, those that are walking sick, those that are just sick, Heavenly Father, continue to lay your hands on them all over them, Heavenly Father, because we know that you are not in the sick room.
Saints of God, that my chairman of the deacon board, Deacon Joe Latif, because he loves boxing,
yes, he does,
that he would be indeed dominant in that boxing gear on today.
Yes.
So I tore up my closet to look for indeed my Muhammad Ali t-shirt.
Ali,
because I feel like a champion on today.
Come on now.
Because the Bible says in 1 John chapter 4 and verse number 4, that greater is he that's within me than he that is in the world. I would love to give an introduction to my two youngest sons who travel with me everywhere I go. They go with me to homecoming at Michigan State University, and I take them there not only to see the game and not only to have breakfast for Tom Izzo, but I take them there because that is my nobody but God spot.
All right. Yeah.
And they keep me in line when I'm there on my old stomping grounds.
Right.
But this morning, Joe Latif asked if he could have the privilege to indeed give the introduction to his boy. Because you know anybody that knows Joe Latif, he loves himself some Justice Jones.
Yes.
And I'm surprised that his grandfather didn't give him a right hook, because he has indeed claimed him as his own. But Joy, since my voice is raspy, why don't you go ahead and give the introduction for Daniel and Justice Jones. And after the choir sings their selection, the next voice you will hear is that of my 10-year-old son, Daniel Jones, and my 13-year-old son who was now 14, who was the valedictorian of the Bergen International School, on his last Friday as an educator, Justice Jones. Indeed, Deacon Lateef is going to come and give the introduction. The choir is going to sing, and prepare your hearts and your mind to receive the word that will be planted on good soil. God bless you.
God bless you.
Amen, church. You know, I've never been in a situation like this before. I don't have any 14-year-old friends.
Okay.
Let me tell you how God works. Because I usually play the role of trying to geek up two young black men to go out there to kill each other for the white man. But this is a little bit different. Pastor Jones drills me with on a regular basis, only what you do for Christ will last. And this boy is a phenomenon. Okay? Because I forget and I'm talking to a 14-year-old. He is just that mature. And Daniel is right behind him. I'm in awe. Because this is the new Metropolitan Baptist Church. You hear me? So I want to introduce the song and present to others. When the choir gets through doing their thing, Daniel and Justice Jones, a dynamic duo.
Baptist Church youth.
Amen.
We had a good time yesterday at Bowling and had Wendy's for lunch.
Yes.
I want to thank my dad, Pastor Jones, for giving me this opportunity to stand before you and teach today.
Amen.
May everybody open their Bibles to Romans. Romans 1 verse 16. And when you have it, I ask you to stand. I'll be reading from the King James Version. It don't matter what version you have. Unless it says B-I-B-L-E,
yes.
That's the book for me.
Amen.
It says in Romans 1 verse 16, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes, first to the Jew and also to the Greek. Let us put a spiritual spotlight on the first 10 words, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. You might be asking yourself, what does it mean to not be ashamed of Jesus Christ? Well, if you are wondering what it means to not be ashamed of Christ, it simply means to not be scared or timid to tell people about Jesus. As a youth, I must admit that there were times where I was ashamed to tell people about Jesus. I had a relationship with God, but I remember knowing Jesus, but afraid to tell people about him. And I know it's people out there who know Jesus and have a relationship with him, but who don't want people to know that they are Christians and don't want their friends to know they follow God. But you got to know in every circumstance, the Lord is with you. It doesn't matter what people say or think about you, because as Jeremiah states in the 20th chapter, verse number 9, but indeed, I cannot.
Amen.
So as Christians, you've got to know and thorns through his skull. So God commands you to tell them. Muslims, we don't want to offend the Jews. We don't want to offend the Arabs. But I want you to know that there will come a time where every Muslim, where every Greek, where every Jew, the other God, Jesus, bright another story. And I come to you again saying, tell the world. Well, that leads me to the gift of technology.
Right.
So me as a follower of God post Bible videos on social media every day.
Right.
And I go to my friends and tell them about Jesus. So we as a church are supposed to do as Matthew 28 verse 19 says, therefore, and go make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, teaching these new disciples to obey everything I have commanded you. So with technology, we can make videos for everyone to see, and people can be saved. For we are in this world that a kiss cannot come, that a kiss will be done. So we've got to use our talents and abilities for people can see us and see the Lord. For we are the salt of the earth and the light of the world, a city upon the hill that cannot be hidden. No matter what age we are, no matter what race we are, we can still let Jesus' light shine.
Yes.
So when we are letting Jesus' light shine, we cannot be afraid, for the Holy Spirit works within us, and he will give us strength. For we can be fishers of men and tell people about Jesus.
Yes.
For we are a chosen nation, handpicked by the Most High God.
Right.
And if he woke us up this morning, it is for a reason. And God saw us, and he said the world will need us. And even if the world mocks us, even if the world nags us, because we are serving the Lord, we have to know, as it says in Matthew chapter 5, verse number 10, blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness, For theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you and say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad.
Yeah.
So you have to have a mindset knowing that I would rather live for Jesus and be judged by men than live for the world and be judged by God. As Jesus said, no man is greater than his master. So if Jesus was persecuted, if Jesus was laughed at, if Jesus was mocked because he followed his father, you will also be too. As I wrap up and close this message, I want to leave you with this. Never be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Always have courage, knowing that you are representing God and you are part of the will of your Father. Let us pray. Heavenly Father God, I come here to say thank you.
Thank you,
Lord, for God, giving us God this new day. A day, Lord, we have never God seen before, and a day we never see again, Lord. I ask you, Lord, give God the youth strength, for Lord, they can God be an instrument of you. Give us strength, Lord. Live within us, Lord. Let us know, Lord, we can do all things through Christ.
And I don't want to take up all of your time. I would like to briefly lecture you on I know who I am.
All right.
I'm going to say that again just in case you didn't hear me.
All right.
Because I know who I am.
Okay.
So that being said, I ask that you all open your Bibles to the book of Luke.
Yeah.
That is Luke chapter 9, coming from the 26th verse. So when you have that, I ask that you stand to your feet and say amen. Because this is indeed another day's journey, and I'm glad about it. Oh, yes, I am. That is, again, Luke chapter 9, verse 26. And it reads, whoever is ashamed of me and my words, the Son of Man will be ashamed of them when he comes in his glory and in the glory of the Father and of the holy angels. Adding spiritual emphasis on that verse, once again it reads, whoever is ashamed of me and my words, the Son of Man will be ashamed of them when he comes in his glory and in the glory of the Father and of the holy angels. You may be seated in the presence of our Lord.
Amen.
But while you're going to your seat, I just want you to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you look pretty good today.
You look pretty
otherwise.
Come on.
Because even that. And would therefore rather me to be ashamed of who I am. So let me stop. Because just as my dad was teaching me to be proud of who I was and what I stood for, and to be unapologetically and unashamedly the young man of God that he was and is currently raising me up to be, I have news for you, Metropolitan. Because we also, as the saints of God, leads me to my first preaching point this morning.
Okay.
Because while I was in the middle of writing this sermon, I was pondering around the question, which was, how can one say that they are a believer and yet are ashamed of what they say they believe in?
Come on.
Because as defined by the Webster's Dictionary, the word ashamed literally means to be reluctant or unwilling to do something because of shame or embarrassment. Therefore, being ashamed of Jesus means being unwilling to identify yourself as a follower of Jesus because of fear of embarrassment, humiliation, ridicule, or disapproval. So I want you to ask yourself a question, church, which is, have you ever been ashamed of Jesus? Have you ever been ashamed of his holy word? And if so, have you ever wondered why? Because if we were to go to John chapter 12, verses 42 through 43, we would then realize that scripture actually answers this very question. So I hope you all kept your Bibles open, so you can't accuse me of making anything. Because it reads, yet at the same time, many even among the leaders believed in him. But because of the Pharisees, they would not openly acknowledge their faith, but feared that they would be put out of the synagogue. For they love praise from men more than they love praise from God. So I like to stop myself right there. Because unfortunately, the problem with a lot of believers, even in our current day, is this. Because at times, we tend to care more of what the world thinks of us than what Jesus thinks of us. Which is why, if we were to go back to the previous few verses, Jesus is letting his disciples know that whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross daily and follow me. For whoever wants to save their life will lose it, but whoever loses their life for me will save it. Because what good is it for a man to gain the whole world and yet lose or forfeit? And the reason Jesus says this is because as believers, he wants us to understand that we are not in it for ourselves, but we are in it for the Savior. Therefore, while we may endure public shame for being who we are, I wish I had some believers that knew, as my brother just said, that there will come a time when every knee shall bow, when every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord, to the glory of God the Father, which is in heaven. Therefore, I don't care what Ray Ray or Lay Lay has to say, because I am a child of God, and I am made in his own and likeness. Therefore, who cares what the surrounding crowd thinks of me, because I am living in his eyes, and I am standing on his holy word, church. And that is why it is written in Romans 10:11 that whosoever believeth in his holy word shall never be put to shame. Because remember, even though we as the saints of God are exempt from being talked about and laughed at from the word, we must never forget that it was Jesus first who was mocked. And just as he overcame, he has instilled within each and every one of us the power to do the same, church. Which leads me to my second preaching point this afternoon, which is simply that it's time to take the leap of faith. Because now that we know what being ashamed is, we must now, as believers, know how to live unashamedly. Because as I touched on earlier, we as the saints of God aren't in any kind of way exempt or immune from mocking, from humiliation, or from embarrassment. Which is why Jesus warns us in John 15:18 that the world hated him first, therefore it will hate all of those who are in him. So indeed, all I'm trying to get you to recognize and realize this afternoon is this. So wake up and write it down. Because suffering is going to be a reality for those who walk unashamedly of the gospel. Because in contrast, those who walk unashamedly of the gospel tend to bail out or run away when faced with hardships and when faced with the mountain. Instead of walking by faith and not by sight, and then believing on all the promises of God.
Yes.
So indeed, the first way to live unashamedly is to possess boldness. Because those who are willingly mocked, those who are willingly humiliated, and even those who are at times disgraced by this world for the sake of Christ and for the sake of the gospel are running headfirst into suffering. And therefore, must have an attitude of boldness.
Yes.
Because we can by no means be around the bush or compromise, but instead we must confront the world with confidence and speak the truth of the gospel, no matter what the repercussions may be.
Yes.
Right.
So in other words, which is the second way to walk unashamedly, which is that we have to be courageous, church.
Yeah.
And such courage comes from the last way to walk unashamedly, which is from conviction. And I know it can get tough at times, dignity.
I know.
But I wish I had some believers in here.
Come on, stand
up and that help.
Yeah.
That who can stand before you when you call on that name of Jesus?
Man.
That's Jesus, the lily of the fact. That's Jesus, our party morning star. That's Jesus, the wheel in the middle of the way.
Yeah.
He has so many names. But when I just think of that good name of Jesus, I said that great name of Jesus.
Yeah.
My soul just cries out, hallelujah. I thank God for saving me.
Yeah.
So I'm about to take my seat and close because I know that you're getting tired of me. But before I do, I just want you to know this. Because as my brother said, yes, we will all endure our own separate trials and tribulations. But we must always remember that God will never put more on us than we can bear.
Come on now.
Indeed, while the devil may have come to kill, to steal, and destroy, Grandpa, God comes so that we can have life and so that we can have it more abundantly.
Hallelujah.
So my word for you this afternoon is this. So just continue to trust in the Lord.
Yes.
And I'm not speaking to just the adults, no. I'm speaking to the youth as well.
Come on.
Because if we as a whole, whether you're one or whether you're 99, just continue to trust in the Lord. And lean not on our own understanding.
Yeah.
But in all thy ways acknowledge Him. He will have our futures to be as bright as the promises of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
The doors of the church are open. If you're here today and you do not have a personal relationship with the God of your salvation, God says, come unto me, all ye that are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. You should not be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. God has never turned his back on you, in spite of all of the wrong things that you have done. In fact, you were doomed. You were dead, and you were disobedient. But thanks be unto God, who gives us the victory through Christ Jesus our Lord. And if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just to forgive us and cleanse us from all sin and unrighteousness. Therefore, no matter what you've done, no matter who you've been with, God says, forget those things which are behind you and press towards the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. Because I don't know about you, but I'm like the choir. I have decided to follow Jesus, and there's no turning back, no turning back. Why don't you look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, are you saved? Do you know Jesus and the power of his resurrection? And if they say no, just say, I want to introduce you to somebody. And his name is Jesus, the lily of the valley, the bright and mighty star. And he will do for you what no other power can do. Indeed, wear it proudly on next week because I'm grateful to you for being a strong black. Anybody that knows Daniel Jones, they know that old lady Robinson loves her some Daniel Jones, and she has called me to talk every day, and I was surprised. I'll pick you out a t-shirt as well, and I cannot bless you. Sister, if $45 will indeed go to the men of the Juneteenth celebration.
Amen.
We want you to invite Lottie, Dottie, and everybody to our Juneteenth celebration on next week, Saints of God, because it's going to be major with indeed Ralph Armstrong and the Ralph Armstrong Trio, who will indeed bless us with the music for that particular day.
Yeah.
And it is Father's Day. And I'm going, my wife says, I love the shop. I'm going to buy every man a pair of socks on next week.
All right.
And indeed, you come with the gym shoes, and we're going to have a sneaker and sock extravaganza and show the world that we are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and we're standing up and letting the world know that we're for Jesus.
Amen.
So indeed, if you're not even in the house on next week, that when I saw a pair to my green bean brother, he don't even want to challenge me on the green beans yet. I can't even hear his name right now. Brother Campbell, Jackie Campbell's husband. And indeed, you want to have some indeed funky socks.
Right.
And indeed, we want you to walk in victory as men.
Right.
Now, Saints of God, I'm about to get the collection, and indeed, I'm going to have Brother Charles, after we take up the collection, to indeed come and receive a love offering, not for these two young preachers, because I'm going to take care of them.
All right.
But the Bible says that you should never make a vow if you plan on breaking the vow.
Right. Amen.
And I want to make sure that it's Scholarship Sunday 2024, because my drummer has plans to go to Texas Southern University.
Ooh.
And I thought he was going to be musically inclined, and he was going to be in music. But he says, I've got a higher calling than that, Pastor.
All right.
Because I want to be a pioneer.
All right.
And I want to make sure that I have at least $500 for him.
All right.
And $500 or more for both him and Zion.
Yes.
So every fifth Sunday is going to be our Scholarship Sunday.
All right.
I'm going to start the offering, love offering off today with $50 after we do our particular tithes and offering. And I just ask that you give our best offering, because I want to indeed leave a legacy. So if I'm not here the second Sunday of June or next year, I know that these two young men and whomever else is coming to be graduates next year will let them know that we're investing in their future.
Yeah.
And letting them know that their future is indeed as bright as the promises of God. So if you are giving on the Giveify app, just put scholarship seed, and we will indeed watch God bring increase into our lives. The ushers are going to come, and we ask that you give your regular tithes and offering. Don't forget the Youth Day offering of $25. Don't forget the Women's Day offering of $99. Give, and it shall be given back to you. Press down, shake it up. For the measure you give will be the measure you receive. Now she's going to come. Thank you. About that on next week. After the benediction, like I said, I ask that you put a seed in the love offering that will go to our scholarship seed so that we would begin to build funds for the scholarship fund in 2024. And you all look so nice in your casual clothing for summer months. I know how we are as people saying to God and say, did you see what sister so-and-so or brother so-and-so had on? Let's all grow together. Don't you check.
Come on.
Let the Lord indeed place on their heart what is in you appropriate, saints of God.
Amen.
Because I better not hear no one
come on.
Running any way away from the Metropolitan Baptist Church.
Amen.
Because they may come as they are, but they won't stay as they are
until
the gospel of Jesus Christ touches their hearts and soul. My little Charles is going to receive the scholarship offering, saints of God. May we all stand and let's go downstairs in fellowship. And for those graduates, keep on shooting for the stars.
Yeah.
Because eyes haven't seen, ears haven't heard, and neither has it entered into the hearts of men the things that God has in store for us. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ be above us to cover us, beneath us to sustain us, in us to fill us, and back of us to push us into everything that God has purposed and ordained for our lives, on the side of us to protect us, and in front of us to lead us, to guide us, and to show us the way. These and many other blessings we ask in your darling Son, Jesus' name. And all the saints of God said together, amen.